26, who is there? Who has the Holy Ghost voice? Nobody? From verse 23. Okay, let me read. And when Gideon perceived that it was an angel of the Lord, Gideon said, "Alas, O Lord God, for because I have seen an angel of the Lord face to face." 25. Go to 25. And it came to pass the same night that the Lord said unto him, "Take thy father's young bullock, even the second bullock of 7 years old, and throw down the altar of Baal that thy father had, and call down the grove that is by it, and build an altar unto the Lord thy God upon the top of the rock in the altar place, and take the second bullock and offer a burnt sacrifice with the wood of the grove which thou shalt cut down." 27. Then Gideon took 10 men of his servant and did as the Lord had said unto him, and so it was, because he feared his father's household and the men of the city, that he could not do it by day, that he did it by night. And when the men of the city arose early in the morning, behold, the altar of Baal was cast down. Before the end of this service, the altars in your father's house will be on the ground. I said, before the end of this service, the altars that have been fighting you will submit before you. 29 or 30. Then the men of the city unto Joash, "Bring out thy son." They came to the boy, his father. "Bring out thy son, that he may die, because he has cast down the altar of Baal, and because he had cut down the grove that was by it." And Joash said, listen to me very well, listen. And Joash said unto all that stood against him, "Will you plead for Baal? Will you save him? He that will plead for him, let him be put to death. Will it is yet morning?" Okay, while it is yet morning, rather, if he be a god, let him plead for himself, because one has cast his altar. Therefore, the last verse, 32. Therefore, on that day, he called him Jerubbaal, saying, "Let Baal plead against him, because he had thrown down his altar." Today, the altars that have been working for your enemies, I command them to expire. I cause them to expire. This evening, the Lord gave me a topic. He said, dealing with altars. Dealing with what? Dealing with altars. And what is an altar? An altar is a sacred place of sacrifice, a sacred place of prayer. Altar, there are two different kinds of altars. I'm rushing because of time. We have the godly altar and the demonic altar. Although many demonic altars today are using the name of Jesus to deceive a lot. Praise God. Many strange altars are using the name of Jesus to deceive many. But whether I like it or not, godly altars are still available. There are godly altars and there are demonic altars. Today, I come as a prophet from the Most High God to pray for you. Any altar eating sacrifices for your sake, they have been taking ram, goat, cow, chicken, fowl, blood, red oil, yam, pepper soup, kai kai, to destroy your destiny. If your amen can be loud, those others shall be pulled down today. There are two altars, demonic altars and the altar of the Most High God. Altar is a place of sacrifice. It's a sacred place. That's why I don't let people cross this altar anyhow. And that is why, after our inauguration, I think nobody has climbed this altar to preach. Because the Lord has not spoken to me. There are people that climb your altar, the altar become polluted. Am I saying something here? Somebody told me, man of God, didn't program invite me once in a while so that my, you know, your people can you know, when they are seeing you every day, they will get tired. I said, you are making sense, because I'm preaching every day, and it's not supposed to be like that. But the Lord told me, don't call if I don't ask you to call. Anyway, I'm not going there. But there are features. I want to go let you know 7 features of the altar. Altar. Gideon. The Lord God woke him up. I called him and said, go and destroy the altar in your father's house. That altar has been the altar speaking against you. That altar has been the altar speaking against your family. No progress. Look at in your family. You are the youngest, even the eldest. Nothing to write about. Nothing good in your family. Tears, crying, weeping, sorrow, anguish, delay, promise and faith, rising and falling, disappointment in your family. And the boy said, God, I'm too young to do this. He said, go, I am with you. I'm the one who sent you. Go, destroy the altar and raise another altar for me. And the boy went at midnight because he was afraid. He brought down the altar. Raised another altar in that same place. And in the morning, the elders of the land came to his house. The boy already ran away. He went and hid somewhere. He came and said, they came and said, Joash, bring out your son. He destroyed our altar. And the man, being a wise man, they told him, he destroyed our altar, our God. He destroyed our God. And he said, do you want to fight for your God? Is he not your God? Let him fight for himself. And they kept quiet. Today, I want to pray for you. All those that have been fighting against you, their mouth will shut down. They waited and waited. Baal could not do anything. It's okay. Let him fight for himself. He's our God. Let him fight for himself. Let him fight for himself. Let him fight for himself. People that have been fighting you, they will keep trying until they come and apologize to you. I said something here last week, or last 2 weeks, how they have been terrorizing me in this place. The same man that insulted me before everybody here, that I threatened, I said, if you remove my wire, you die. The man came to me today with his mouth very big. I said, Pastor, please, I'm dying. Pastor, help me with small money. I want to go and remove something in my mouth. See the mouth very big like this. I said, oh God, my rent is not due. He said, don't worry, just give me any money, please. I'm dying. Please. He became my friend automatically. Anybody that have been tormenting you, God will show them pepper. Anybody, whether or not you're a landlord, landlady, heaven will flog them. And I saw his mouth very big. I said, I will give you the money. But in my mind, I was saying, yes, God, appear like I want. You don't threaten, you don't talk to a man of God anyhow. Yes, I will give you. Come on Sunday. If money enter my hand, I will give you something. You can remove anything that is wrong with your man. Any altar, I remember one night, he came here. I said, see, Ogu, Ogu, something in his pocket. I don't know what is the thing. The thing was big. He said, Ogu, Pastor, I'll kill you. I'll kill you. I said, Ogu. I said, Ogu. Ogu, Abi. Okay. Oh, yeah, Ogu, Mina. He said, no, my child, you be this. My Ogu, Ogu, Ogu. Anyone that be trying you, they will come and become your friend because they cannot get you. Somebody set fire, yeah, 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 yeah. Set fire, yeah, yeah, yeah. Set fire, yeah, yeah. Set fire, yeah, yeah. Set fire everywhere. I think I was with Joshua when he was that little boy Joshua. He can bear witness of what I'm saying. Bah! Could not talk because somebody brought him down. He couldn't fight for himself anymore. The man, Gideon's father said, let Baal fight for himself. Don't fight for him. Let him speak for himself. They waited and waited. They waited and waited. Baba no balule. Opupu no na la lula. Bring it down. They waited and waited. That was how that boy escaped. Baal couldn't do anything. And Gideon did not die. Today, I come as an oracle. God told me when I was praying. He said, my son, deal with altars today. Every altar that is carrying your case, if I be a servant of God, that altar will be arrested by fire. They will be arrested by fire. If you are here and you think that there are no altars, you are a liar. There are wicked altars. I went for land liberation somewhere. Altar may not be just a shrine. Now, technology is taking all over. Everything now is online. Praise the Lord. Everything is online. Everything is online. You won't born picking, they can born online. You won't marry, you can marry online. You won't build us, you can build online. You won't buy anything, you can buy online. They won't do wedding. They can do wedding online. Online wedding, you plenty. Online. People will never see themselves. They don't marry online. Praise the Lord. Technology. Altar now, you don't need a place again. They don't need the some native doctor now. They don't need all those things. Even I see one of Allah will get laptop. I don't know which you take laptop, they do. If they find customer. I saw another one on Facebook. It was advertising his nonsense. He said, I'll make you a billionaire. Call my number online. Praise the Lord. Altars may not be just that the one you see in Babala in Hollywood. They put something. Some altars are moving altars. Are human altars. That is the New Testament altar for the Christians. I'm coming to that area. But there are wicked altars standing as men, as women. If you think that there are no wicked altars, you are a liar. There are altars. There are altars that are standing against people's destiny. That say, over that dead body, will they see you rise? That say, never, never, never. Because of the blood of Jesus Christ shed for me and you, those altars today, they will bow before you. They have upgraded, though. Which have upgraded, though. Which have upgraded. Everything is upgraded. Which don't upgrade. Don't wait until they come and they wear black and they get long finger. And get long eye. And I want to tire me. I don't know. Women waiting up. They'll get go and give their eye, they put on that one. And the worst part, then they see, then they close up 1 minute. Then they open up 1 minute. And so you can go, they be like, you know this trailer with the highway, where they do like this. You go like, you know be Abino, you declaim Abino. It didn't tire me. You know tire you? See, now then they talk about it. Praise the Lord. Everything has upgraded. So powers, these two powers, they have upgraded. Papa Deboye said something. That the difference between American witch and the African witch is illiteracy. Your own witch, they go school. Our own witch, no go school. Your own witch, they use their witch to do many, many things. Good things to develop. Our own witch, they don't go school. They can they kill themselves. More than an illiterate witch or literate witch. Holy Ghost! Suffer not the witch to. Witch is not part of the law. Saul killed all the witch, all the witches in the land of Israel. Number one, a place of sacrifice. Exodus 20, 24. Somebody quickly read that place. Exodus 20, 24. Altar is a place of sacrifice. I want to rush because of my time. We need to pray and deal with the altars. An altar of earth thou shalt make unto me, and shall sacrifice thereon thy burnt offering and peace offering, thy sheep, thy oxen. In all places where I record my name, I will come unto thee and I will bless thee. Altar. Please sacrifice. Please. Sometimes you go to the village, even Lagos here, you see some dogs and you see sacrifice. Red oil, yam, pepper soup. My father used to tell me how they used to visit one junction. Anytime they're coming from school, him and his friends. Anytime they pass that junction, they will see yam. And the mistake the Babala will make, he will cook the yam. Cooked yam with red oil, sometimes meat, and they will put one bottle of Fanta. And there was a day I was coming back. He was hungry. And he was praying for food. And the Lord led him through that road again. And he said, Lord, today, let there be a sacrifice. And behold, there was a sacrifice. And he washed his hand in the river close to the sacrifice. And said, Father, bless this food. He dipped his hand and ate and drank Fanta. And washed his hand and went home. Every ugly sacrifice that they kept for you, somebody will eat it. Say, somebody will eat it. Because the God cannot answer the prayer again. They have eaten his food. Enough, you walk. Are you with me? They have eaten his food. He cannot walk. When they tell them, say, bring goats. And you bring that goat, somebody steals that goat. The prayer when they won't pray for you, you know if you walk. Oh. Because the sacrifice is missing. I declare every sacrifice in the wicked altar fighting you to miss now. Praise the Lord. Sacrifice or altar rather is a place of sacrifice. Sacrifice. Drop sacrifice. Sacrifice. Please learn how to be a sacrificer. I don't preach it here, but once in a while I teach you, but it works. And I do it. I don't preach money here, but I must tell you sometimes learn how to give sacrifice. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. You can't sacrifice on a good altar. There was a man I was praying for. I pray for the man. Pray, I tire. I said, wait. I pray, I tire. I said, wait. I said, okay, I'm tired. Go and buy a living, buy anything that has blood. He said, Pastor, which water go buy? I said, I don't know. Now, which are here? Go buy. He got to a booking place. He called me, Pastor, I see ram, I see goat. Which one? I said, okay, I don't know. Buy anyone. He bought a big goat. Not in this place. I was working in a church. He brought the goat. And I told him, I'm not praying. Your prayers are answered. I'm not even the one that ate the goat. It was the church people. and he has been looking for visa for a very long time. After he dropped that sacrifice, that week that brother traveled to Germany. You want to clap, you clap. I didn't pray. He brought sacrifice. I said, you are blessed. God bless you and sacrifice. Go. He tied it outside. And they touched, they shared the meat. When the pastor came, he saw goat. Who brought goat again? I said, Daddy, someone I pray for. That's what God asked me. And the brother went to jail. Let me tell you, sometimes sacrifice opens door for you. Are you hearing me? I didn't say to sacrifice in this altar. You can sacrifice anywhere, but let it be a godly altar. Sacrifice open doors for you. Altar is a place of sacrifice. Number two, the altar must be clean and beautiful. Look at this altar, very beautiful. Somebody clap for Jesus. It's a beautiful altar. Praise the Lord. It's a beautiful altar. It must be clean and beautiful. You can see it in the Bible. It's in the Bible. 1 Kings 7:48. Check it, is there. That must be beautiful. That's why all these people say, don't climb here. Oh, yeah. Let the house of God be clean. Because there is something you don't understand about being clean. Who is there? 1 Kings 7:48. Quickly. We need to pray. Because altars must bow today. Read. And Solomon made all the vessels that pertained unto the house of the Lord, the altar of gold, and the table of gold, whereupon the showbread was. Altar of gold. Solomon made an altar of gold. Of gold. Is that not a beautiful thing? Altar of gold. Is that decorated this altar you are saying? The sister that decorated it. After decorating it, we used it. His altar has been here at the 1st of December. That was the day we decorated this altar. To January 1st. I think it was that same January. God gave her a powerful car. Praise the Lord. How many of you were here that day? The person I'm talking about is in our midst. She's here. After decorating the house of God, somebody gave her a car that was 3 million plus. Not motor, not car, machine. The car is even outside. Praise the Lord. So when the altar is clean, is neat, God is happy. You can decorate the house of God and remain the same. Praise the Lord. That's altar. Number three, altar must be on fire. Leviticus 6:12. Altar must be on fire. Must be on fire. Leviticus, who is there? I'm rushing because of time. Leviticus 6:12. Let me read. And the fire upon the altar shall be burning in it. It shall not be put out. And the priest shall burn wood on it every morning and lay upon it. Now, the fire on the altar is prayer. Now, this one is for we, the priests. We need to be praying every time on the altar. Kalabababa. People, where they come see me now, every day they plenty. I beg, if you don't see me, just come pray for altar. I'm even trying to fix a day now, just one day for canceling. People, where they come every day, you don't let me man pray. So when you come, if I'm not around, come and pray on the altar. There are some nights I stand here, night till morning, praying. Some of you have met me like that. You enter here, you meet me praying here. That is in the Bible. The altar must be on fire. So if you come, if you don't see man of God, don't feel discouraged. Pray. Drop your seed or pray and go. Believe. Because this altar is on fire. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. The altar must be on fire. Likewise, demonic altar is always on fire. Always on fire. They always start to do sacrifice. Every time they give this, give that, give this, give that. Because they want to put make it, they want it to be on fire. But when power jump power, the smaller power will do what? Any pastor when they sleep, native doctor when they sleep, you go kill them. Eh? Christian when they sleep, your neighbor na witch, you know they sleep. He go pass, he go deal with you. It'll be on fire. You are an altar. You are an altar on your own. You are an altar on your own. Fire. Prayer. If not for prayer, what is happening here can't happen here. I'm the only person that's entered here. And people that own this place, they dance to my tune. What is the secret? Prayer. I take over. God, if you sent me here, bring them under my feet. I take over. Prayer. I'm the only person that has entered here, and the people that own this place, they are dancing to my tune. Others, they will deal with them anyhow. It's prayer. You must be on fire as an altar, so that you can put the other altar in disaster. They will keep trying, they get tired. Cat entered here, came and shit on the altar. And they thought they would scatter the ministry. I said, okay, thank God I saw you. We saw the cat here, Korokoro. I said, thank God, God arrested you. I know what to do. I don't have more to say. It's only prayer. Nime chineke ebere bogumboro aga magwo yoso. It's okay, bring it down, become time. Prayer, na prayer you go chop. Okay, when I come shit for altar, no problem. I know where to go. Karaba sutenene gedi raba shabala badaya. Rika praka suka tapa. Rada. The cat, the witch, you know the fear. Come shit for altar for here. And God arrested the cat. He could not go. He was hiding there. Couldn't go. Workers, Fiji. Workers, am I saying the truth? The witch could not go. He stayed. The big cat. He stayed there. He did not come out. We pray. Pray again. See, whatever you are saying, it matters. So the cat did not come out. We pray. Oh, shut fire. He did not come out. As I carry the rug where he shit, this rug, place on this altar. And I said, I want to judge you, evil cat. The cat begin to cry. Somebody said, where is this cat crying from? Where is the cat? And they saw the big cat there. I'm not used to killing all these things. We said, let the idiot go. We opened door, he refused to follow door. It was through window. It was wrestling. He refused to follow door. Now pure winch with that. Pure winch. Winch, you don't follow door. If it's the follow door. Yes, I will not kill you physically, but maybe I will get you spiritual. Things are happening. How did the cat enter here? I don't know. Where did he enter? I don't know. He entered. The way he entered, he can't go again. Fire arrested him. And God wanted him to wait. We see cat don't shit anyhow. They shit on the ground and bury it. How can shit on the altar? In front of my altar. Don't fire the devil. I said, I know what I'm going to do. Now prayer, you go chop me. Let me stay hungry for one day for your head, and let me see how you survive it. Somebody be on fire. Shut fire. Yeah. Be on fire. Don't be a lukewarm Christian. Don't be a butter and bread Christian. You don't fear your neighbor. Where they do jump, don't fire the devil. When you don't know who you are. When there is witch in your compound, call me. I like that kind of case. Witches and wizards. They are my friend because we know where we meet. Praise the Lord. Number four, please clear your heart before going to God's presence, to God's altar. Matthew 5:24. Please, before coming to church, to give offering. Clear your heart. That's what the Bible is talking about there. Clear your heart before coming to God's water. Clear your heart. Clear your heart. Husband, clear your heart where your wife is. Wife, clear your heart where your husband is. Clear your heart. So that God will bless you. He do me this, he do me that. Wait till it happen. He do you this, he do you that. He don't know say God do you before you marry him. He must do you that, you know. Forgive and forget. You come and give offering. You carry, you give offering. Now you go dance pass. But if they quarrel for house, so, as if they go as, if they go as, you go tell your, that they follow there, me, and they follow here. So now they come, as na, some of them now, as na, they go house, when they talk to my husband, do, see that they're there. As they go as now, they talk to the husband. When I go dance pass for church, shout fire, fire! Praise the Lord. I beg your husband must offend you. Your wife must offend you. When he offend you, try to forgive and forget. Especially when you are coming to church, clear your mind. Read the place now. Nobody's there. Oh, leave it. It's a popular place. Before you come to church to give offering, let your heart be pure. The God's altar. Before you call this altar, please, it will help my prayer to move very fast. I will pray, 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 pray. Nothing. Something is holding it. I never go dirty dollar before. Somebody was asking me. He said, man of God, what can I do for you? Do you need any business? Do you need anything? I said, my business is this ministry. It's my business. And I pray for all of you every day. I'm living for God because I would have died many, many years ago. I'm living for this ministry. I will pray, 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 pray. No result. Check yourself. Who are you angry with? Who are you angry with? So that the prayer will go. We move. Even the witches and wizards that I know, I still greet them. We know where we meet. I don't fight physical battle. We meet somewhere. I will say, good morning, yo. Mama, good morning. Good afternoon. You want to take? But we know where we are going to meet. So please, it's not a physical thing. Don't quarrel, physical quarrel with your enemies. Praise the Lord. So clear your heart. Number five, the gift on the altar. The gifts on the altar are sacred gifts. Okay, Matthew 23:18-19. What am I going to say there? Just write down Matthew 23:18-19. Please, you want to give God something, let it be a good thing. Praise the Lord. If you want to give God something, let it be a good thing. Let me not talk about offering now. Offering is different. Because sometimes, in 5 naira, we see an offering. Bring it down. The 5 naira is an offering. It's bigger than our basket. Well, let me leave that one. Because we have children. But I'm saying, if you want to give God a sacrifice, don't give God leftover. Leftover. A man of God used to preach. How somebody brought a chicken. Chicken is about to die. He brought it to God. You see the chicken. Even the juju, when they walk again, you know, accept them. The chicken, when we say, the neck don't dry, no feather. And they see the bone. The hand, no feather. Even the chicken, you know, they feel, you know, they run. Now, waka, they waka. They're not tired, but we know they run. They put up for head and say, like that. Pastor, they look. He said, did you bring it to thank God? He said, yes, man of God. He said, you bought? Even some chicken, when they waka on their own, they get life past that one. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. To God's altar. And you want God to answer that kind of prayer. It's better you don't bring anything. No. Let man of God pray for you. If you want to do anything in the altar, let it be a good thing. It's in the Bible. Because altar always works with sacrifice. It could be your offering, it could be your tithe, it could be your seed or anything. If you don't have no problem, if you want to do it, let it be a good thing. Praise the Lord. Then, number six, let it be clean also. Clean items to godly altars. Clean items. You see these native doctors, sometimes they give their only child. They give their only child. Somebody that was fighting the children of God, or a group of people, army, fighting God's children. What did a man do? He went and killed the heir to his throne. And God said, no. This man's sacrifice is too much. God withdrew himself from his own people. And his enemies destroyed the people of God. Sometimes sacrifice needs to move for you. I want to pray for you. May God teach you how to defeat your enemy with your sacrifice. Last but not the least, away time. Romans 12 verse 1. Somebody read there. Everybody go there. I'm running up with that. Everybody go there. Romans 12 verse 1. We are praying now. We are praying right now. Romans 12 verse 1. Listen. I beseech you therefore, brethren, be by the mercies of God that ye present your body a living what? Holy, acceptable unto which is your reasonable what? The greatest sacrifice is your life. Your life. Your what? Be born again. Live a holy life. Say no to sin. Run from iniquity. Run from sin. S-I-N. It is the fastest killer. It can kill more than HIV, more than Ebola, more than coronavirus. Sin. Your body should be a temple of the Holy Ghost. That is the highest sacrifice. The highest what? Sacrifice. Your life. You don't have money. You don't have this. Or even if you have money, you have this. You give God this. If your body is not an altar, it's not like a sacrifice to God, then you are far away from God's blessings. There are some things people that live right with God enjoy that sin has not enjoyed. Even though you are a churchgoer. A churchgoer doesn't qualify you to be a Christian. I was preaching in the market on Friday and I was telling them that you don't need to be a prophet before you go make heaven. You must not go to church before you make heaven. All you need is a holy life. They sold them and called them Christians in Antioch because they were behaving like Christ. Are they calling you Christian? Who are you? Are you an altar of God or an altar of darkness? You have to present yourself as a living sacrifice to God. Praise Master Jesus. Ask your neighbor, are you a living sacrifice? Are you a living sacrifice? Answer him, Ohana. You sure? Are you sure? Then I say, God, they see you. Then I say, God, they see you. You must live a good life. Sometimes when some case come to you, you tell God, God, what did I do? Who have I offended? Me, I still say it every time. I say, if I've gone to native doctor with these two legs before, Father, disgrace me. Or I have gone to seek power anywhere. Or I do RNG. They pay some people money. They come and do magic in the church. But if it's just you, only you, those that are fighting me, Father, disgrace them. That's my own prayer. I pray sometimes on my own. You, what do you pray to God? Can God be proud of you? Anywhere you belay face, you carry your leg, enter. You talk anything. You go anywhere. You just enter anywhere. As a temple of God, you don't enter anywhere. You don't go anywhere they invite you. You have to live a godly life.
You are a sacrifice.
Praise the Lord.
You are a temple. You are an altar. You need to be on fire. Focus. Be focused and be on fire for God.
Be on your feet. We are about to pray.
Our prayers today, we are dealing with evil altars.
But I want to let you know, if you want to deal with altars, if you are not yet a born again, give a life to Jesus. You have to say no to sin. As we sing this song,
how could you love a man?
Leave the song. Let's sing a surrender song to Jesus.
Draw me nearer to thee. Oh Lord, draw me nearer.
Please don't go
outside. Closer to thee, oh Lord, draw me closer to thee. My song, every day, Father, draw me closer.